they don't want to succumb to this. On and on and on, the same things happen. Most people don't even realize, it's not lifetime to lifetime, that is also there. But within this life, you don't have to admit it in front of people, but I want you to sincerely look at this.
Namaskaram Sadhguru. What does the path of Brahmacharya involve? How do I know whether I am capable of that?
Brahmacharya means to be like the breeze. That is, you don't stick to anything. It's going everywhere. We don't know where it's coming from right now. Just cross the oceans and come. Here it is. It just keeps going. Brahmacharya means simply just being life, just to live the way you were born, alone. Even if your mother happened to bear twins, you still were born alone. In a very close association with the Divine. Just to live like that. Brahmacharya is not a great step. Just to exist as life is. Marriage is a great step. You're trying to do something very big. At least people believe so. Brahmacharya means you did nothing. You allowed your life to happen, just the Creator made you. You don't make anything out of it. To be on the path of Brahman or the Creator, just to be His way, not your way. Marriage, you get married thinking it's going to be your way, but it's going to be somebody else's way. So Brahmacharya means just His way, the way He made you, just to be like that. No step. If you don't do anything, you're a Brahmachari. But there is sadhana, there is other disciplines. What is that about? That is just to help you to stay like that, because once you picked up material from this planet, once you pick up substance from this planet, the qualities of this planet will enter you and try to rule you. One basic quality of once you pick up earth is there is something called as inertia. So, to be in the path of the Divine means not to give in to the way of the earth. One thing is inertia, another thing is a compulsive movement. If you pick up a piece of this earth, you become like the earth. It tries to take you in circles. Cyclical movement is the basis of everything that you call as physical in the universe. The physical can exist only if it is cyclical. Brahmacharya means you don't want to succumb to the cyclical moment, because a Brahmachari has realized that the world can do without him, so he doesn't want to come back. See, cycle means if you move in a circle, however large the circle is, you come back, isn't it? Even if you're not invited. Yes or no? Once you're on a circular path, invariably you will come back. We don't know whether people want you or not, whether the world wants you or not, but you'll anyway come back because you're in a circle. So those who have realized that they're not really wanted around here, they want to be on a straight path, the path of the Divine, not the planetary trajectory. So, to see that you do not succumb to the ways of the planet, because if you're identified with this, you are just a piece of the planet. Everything that you have is borrowed from this planet and it will rule you from within. So one takes on to brahmacharya instead of as a natural process, as a path, as a discipline, so that they don't get into cyclical motion of life. They don't want to succumb to this. On and on and on, the same things happen. So, what does it involve? If you're very conscious, it involves nothing. Very simple. You wake up every day in the morning like you were born. You go to sleep like you would die. In between, whatever is useful to everybody, you do, because you're still not reached a place where you can exist without activity. You need to do something. The idea is that activity should be never about you. Because if the activity is about you, you will pile up entanglement. So you constantly do activity which is not about you. You do that much activity, when you go to bed, you don't have a moment, you fall like you're dead. When you wake up before the birds, get busy. Rest will be taken care of by grace. Need not do too much, because we invest a certain amount of energy to manufacture a brahmachari. Actually, it shouldn't be necessary. If they simply didn't do anything, they would be there. But the ways of the earth rule from within, because after all, you can't keep your body down. It has memory, it's a huge karmic pile. So it has its tendencies. To go beyond these tendencies, which are not natural to your being, but it is like, because this vehicle tends to go like this. Suppose you are driving a car and it has a little alignment problem, it keeps pulling like that, you have to straighten it, otherwise it'll go. This is just like that. This has an alignment problem. It always wants to go like this. Once it bends, it's just a question of time before it completes the circle. But because it is taking a certain period of time and one's awareness is not in any great place, every time you pass the same spot, it looks like a new place. It will. If you sat here in the afternoon, the same place where you're sitting, the whole place would look different if it's sunny and in a different way. Now you sit, it looks different. Come at 12 in the night and sit down, it looks different. So you think it… you come to a different place every time. But no, it's just a question of time, season and short memory because of a certain mathematic involved in the movement of the planet. Generally your cycles are little over 12 years. Same spot you keep hitting. Most people don't even realize. It's not lifetime to lifetime, that is also there. But within this life, every 12 and a half years you're going through a cycle. Most people never even notice it, that the same things are happening. Most people, 99.9% of the people don't notice, very few people notice the same situations, and both physiological, psychological and outside situations, similar things are coming by. If you're little hyper, it will come every 6 years. If you're a little more hyper, it'll come every 3 years. Much more hyper, it'll come once in 18 months. Much, much more hyper, it'll come once in 3 months. If it comes below 3 months, you shouldn't be here, you should be in a mental asylum. Yes. If your cycles are less than 3 months, for sure you're dangerous for yourself and everybody around you. You should be in an asylum. Because your cycles are so short, you will become volatile, dangerously volatile. So, whether you're doing a 12-year cycle or you're doing a 3-month cycle, it's just the difference is only question of percentages of madness, isn't it? If you're doing 3 months, everybody can see that you're mad. If you're doing 12-year cycles, people don't make out, but you know. If you're sincere, you know you're crazy. If you're straight with yourself, you clearly know you're crazy. Only thing is, because it's 12.5 years or so, you can fool the world that you're okay. I want you to, all of you to look at this. Sincerely look at yourself. Don't worry about the social impact. You don't have to admit it to anybody, okay? Within yourself, aren't you quite insane? Don't have to say anything. You don't have to admit it in front of people. But I want you to sincerely look at this. If you're sincere and straight about yourself, you know you're quite off. If you've admitted this to yourself, you want to fix it. But you've become so much of a social being, how you are doesn't matter, how you look is all that matters to you. Then you can go on. Many lifetimes you can go on. How you are matters to you, your being has become very important for you, not what somebody thinks about you. It is not another person's opinion which is crafting your life. It is the nature of your being. If that happens, you will naturally be on the path of the divine. You will want to be there. There is no other way.